إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد. All praise is due to Allah. We praise Him. We seek His help. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls, from the evil of and from the evil of our actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, none can misguide him. And whomsoever Allah leaves him go astray, none can guide him. And I bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad, peace be upon him, is his slave and messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Amma ba'd. My sisters in Islam, jazakumullahu khair, may Allah reward you for the hijab. Especially those who are wearing the hijab as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has instructed them. But I would like to ask for those other sisters who are wearing hijab and the ones who are wearing for the sake of Allah and the ones who are wearing the hijab for the sake of Allah as well as for the sake of something else. Sisters, hijab is a command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My question is, did you ask yourselves, whatever you are wearing today, is it what Allah and His Messenger instructed you? When you stand in the morning in front of that mirror and you look at yourself, do you say to yourself, do you check how you are wearing your hijab? Do you say to yourself, is this what Allah wants from me? Do you check that you're fulfilling the command of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or you fulfill your desire? Do you look at yourself and say, oh, do I look good at this? If you are doing so, well, you are wasting your time. If you are wearing it because it has to be, you know, looking good, you have to look good at it, you have to wear it certain way, therefore you have wasted. Subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not accept any deed from anyone without two conditions. Number one, you have to be sincerely doing it for His sake alone and none else. Number two, you have to follow the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam's command and instructions in terms of wearing the hijab or any other ibadah. So therefore, if you are wearing the hijab because it looks good at you, you look good at it, yeah, you're looking at yourself, then you are there to show off and to sell yourself to the public. Again, that is public property. You are not wearing for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And yawm al-qiyamah, you will come without reward. And not only that, you are a sinner because you made it up. You not followed the rules. Billahi alaykum, sisters. If you go to any place, you fulfill the rules. If you are working for someone or you are employed in any company, you have to fulfill their rules without questions. You say this is the rules. You live in a country, you say this is the law. But subhanallah, when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we want to do how we want it. Okay, why don't you pray the way you want? Well, you are wearing the hijab the way you want. Why don't you just start praying, maybe just kneeling or putting your hands up, you know, holding your hands up. Well, I can pray this way, it looks nice. Or maybe your hand at the back, that looks nice. Why can't we pray how we want? Why can't you fast how you want? And why can't you do hajj how you want? You can't. You have to follow Allah and His Messenger's rule. Therefore, if that is the case, sisters, isn't it the time that you wear the hijab according to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam? We know Muslim women wore the niqab from the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam up to the time of the colonies in our Muslim countries. Before that, after the colonies, when things changed and niqab became kind of history. And nowadays we say niqab is not obligatory, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has informed us in Surah Al-Ahzab, verse 59. That's Surah 33, verse 59. Allah has instructed the Muslim woman to cover fully from head to toe. And by the way, hijab in Arabic, hijab, the word hijab means the things that, you know, screens you. Now, this wall behind me is a hijab for me. No one can see me. The people out there, they cannot see me because I have this hijab. I have this veil, barrier. Therefore, the word hijab means something that conceals the whole body. And it has conditions. You will have to read those conditions. It has to be, the cloth has to be thick, not fat, you know, has to be fatfad. It has to be thick and it has to be roomy. And it has to be one color, black. As Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, when the verses of hijab were revealed, the women of Medina, they were like crows. Crow is black. That means they were all dark. They were all wearing something black. So subhanallah, this was the hijab. And they all wore niqab. Now, even if we come to the point that niqab is not obligatory and it's a sunnah, if we argue, for argument's sake, oh sisters, we know the hadith of Qudsi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he says, وَمَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهُ. My slave keep on coming close to me until I love him. By doing what? النَّوَافِل. By doing the optional things. Now, even if it's optional, don't you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to love you? Don't you want His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be proud of you? If that's the case, why don't you wear the niqab? Why don't you stand by your sisters wearing niqab, sisters? Those sisters, the few sisters, those strangers who are wearing the niqab, why don't you be like them, sisters? Why don't you wear the niqab so that Allah will reward you? Don't you want sunnah? Subhanallah, the one who will say it's sunnah and walk away from sunnah. Subhanallah, are you happy with the deed that you are doing? The sunnah will complete for you yawm al-qiyamah, your deeds. Therefore, why don't you wear the niqab, sisters? And why don't you wear jilbab, even if you're not wearing niqab, sisters? Wear the jilbab. Don't wear the hijab because it suits you. Don't wear something colorful and not the style that nowadays they do. They have to put extra pillowcase in there or pillows. And it looks like London bus. It just looks like, you know, red bus, you know, double-decker bus. Subhanallah. And this is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam talked about, like a hump of a camel. Subhanallah. So don't be like that head camel's head. Rather, follow the instruction of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and fear Allah, sisters. Fear Allah, because today, if you're not wearing, those who are not wearing hijab altogether, yeah, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will be shrouded. You will wear hijab whether you like it or not, the day you will be returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your grave alone. So before that day comes, sisters, fear Allah. Don't go out there perfumed, yeah, beautified yourself, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said any woman who goes there beautifying herself, yeah, she is kada wa kada. She is like adulterous woman. May Allah save you from that. But wallahi, whenever I see a sister who's wearing niqab, I just make dua for her. May Allah protect her from the evils of societies of today. Wallahi, she put our heads up, mashallah. So may Allah protect you, sisters. Sisters, fear Allah, fear Allah, fear Allah, and wear the hijab according to Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not to according to your desire. Don't follow your desire. Follow Allah and His Messenger's command. وجزاكم الله خير وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.